What do you love about Donald Trump?
I love everything about Donald Trump. I feel he can be trusted and feel comfortable, and it's peace of mind.
And tell me a little bit about what you liked when he was president. What are some of the things he did that you agreed with?
I agreed with everything he did.
One specific?
I can't think on the spot, but everything I'm happy with.
Don't let the answers to our very own Michael Shore's questions fool you. While he was speaking to Trump supporters during a Trump rally in South Carolina, several of them did outline what they specifically liked about Donald Trump and why they continue to support him. So let's watch the next video.
What did you like about the first 4 years of his presidency? What accomplishments would you like to see continue?
Save the children. Most important thing is what's happening to our children.
Explain.
The infiltration of our education system and the abduction of our children. Over 800,000 a year go missing in the United States alone. They are taking so many of them and torturing them for adrenochrome.
Prices, gas right now is crazy. Can't, I mean, my husband's a truck driver and the gas prices are insane. We can't even make a living basically because we're having to pay for gas.
Reducing regulations on business, let conservative thrive. The economy was better.
I'm Hispanic and I really think that he helped this country securing the South border.
So a lot of issues were brought up there, protecting the children, I'm assuming from human trafficking, lower gas prices is what they're hoping they would get from a second Trump presidency, and also reducing regulations on business. And I gotta be honest, that part was very traditional conservative Republican, right? Yeah. So that made a lot of sense. And that's actually what Trump did during his time in office. So he seemed to be the one who was the most justified in his support for Donald Trump, because what he wants, he's gonna get. But to be fair, a lot of Democrats like deregulation as well. Nonetheless, I'm curious what you think, Cenk.
Yeah, so I watched a lot of these interviews. And so when you, and we've done more than just the South Carolina one, we've done this endlessly. And when you actually take the time to talk to Trump supporters, you find out things that are both not what the mainstream media tells you, right? And sometimes in a positive way. And you also find out things that are super disturbing. You get both, okay? There's no, the both sides are wrong, right? So the Democrats a lot of times make it seem like every MAGA person is and every Trump and every Republican voter is a lunatic, okay? And the other side says, no, all the Democrats are lunatics, right? So no, they're saints. These guys are saints in real America.
Yeah,
right?
Look, there are very fine lunatics on both sides.
Yes, so now having watched them as objectively as I could. So there's a couple of things. Number one, some of them have no idea why they're supporting Donald Trump. Never even thought about it. They're just reflexively because it's cultural.
Vibes.
Okay, it kind of, because one guy said, everyone I know supports Donald Trump, right? And for those of you living on the coast, you're like bewildered by that. But if you're in a very progressive area, right? Just imagine the same exact thing, but everyone is conservative. And everyone is gaslighting you that Trump is like the greatest guy in the world and he's sticking up for us, etc. Like, are you sure you'd be able to resist that? Because we're tribal and that's how we act as human beings. Okay, so yes, some of them had no reason at all, and I'll come back to that. But some of them did have reasons, regulation, inflation, and I might not agree with a lot of their reasons. And when Michael asked them for facts, there weren't a lot, right? So like one of guys said, hey, you know what, Trump brought down unemployment. Well, that's actually a little bit true, so there's a fact. And Obama had brought it from like 11 or 12% where Bush left it down to 5%. And then Trump brought it to around 4%. So he decreased it a little bit. Now, did they give Obama credit for decreasing it massively? No. Then did Biden decrease it from Trump? Yes, but they don't believe that. They think, no, it's unemployment is higher now. It's not true. Unemployment is lower than Trump's, right? So there are actual facts and they get a lot of them wrong, which goes to Anna's main point, which is
yes,
where are they getting the information?
Yes, Cenk, okay. Yes. Okay. Yes. 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 Okay. Yes. That's the point I was gonna make.
I know.
Okay.
Okay. So let me get there. So you're definitely still not gonna like some of my answers.
No. No. It's okay. As long as you understand that, again, like you guys, the filter bubbles are so powerful, and it's just important to keep that in mind before jumping to conclusions about whether someone is inherently like a terrible person that can't be saved and, you know, is worthless. Like, I hate that kind of talk. But anyway, continue.
So like when you look at something like the guy saying, oh, they're abducting the children in Andranochrome or Andromeda Galaxy or whatever the hell the crazy conspiracy theories are, right? So that's the one where they rip off the kid's face and wear the thing and then drink their blood and blah, blah, blah. And they genuinely believe it, right? So, okay, that's easy to go, oh, lunatics, right? And they are. But they got that from Bob on Facebook, or it was Alex Jones hinted at it, or some guy on Fox News, and then they did search, and they have a whole methodology the right wing leaders do of they find like Google bubbles where there's no information, mm-hmm. and they'll insert a word that then they'll put into the talking points of all the right wing media. So when people go to search for it on Google, like Andranochrome or whatever this thing is, all they get is all of the links seem to say, yeah, it's true, the Democrats rip the face off the kids after they molest them and then drink their blood to be younger. Because they picked the Google bubble where no one else is talking about a made up thing that they created, right? So that's one bubble, right wing media, Fox News, etc., Newsmax is another bubble. So that's where they're getting from. Now, having said that, in terms of why they like Trump, the core question that Michael's asking in these videos, two things stand out as usual. One is he's anti-establishment. That's the part mainstream media never, ever, ever talks about, because they are the establishment and they don't want to legitimize someone becoming popular because they were talking against the establishment. And they'll say things like he's honest, right? Now, Trump is not honest. He's the least honest politician in American history. But since he doesn't act and talk like a robot, the kind of fake plastic politicians that mainstream media loves, they also never acknowledge that. No, they keep saying it over and over again. They think the guy is honest because he's real. He doesn't read from a prompter, etc. Honest and real are not the same thing. Okay, he's a real idiot, but he's not honest about the facts. So last thing, yes. And then there is that portion that says he's for us and America and our values and our way of doing things. Now, do they, and to the left, let me just clarify. Do you think those guys go home and go, ah, man, black people are inferior, gay people are inferior, and I love being better than them? Do some portion of them do that? Yes, I think some portion of them get, if not exactly there, very close to there, right? But a much bigger proportion don't think that they're racist or bigoted or homophobes at all. They just never even thought about it. They just thought us, right? And here's this Trump guy who's a big bully that fights for us. But they never thought through what's us, what's inside the wagons and what's outside the wagons, right? And so is that a form of racism, bigotry, etc.? It is, but are they evil? And they have made an active decision to be evil. And guys, I say this, so one more thing and then we'll get back to the videos. Like they say it about me as a Muslim, right? I grew up Muslim and I've had right wingers say to my face all the time, oh, you're an atheist now? Thank God, at least you're not a Muslim anymore. Now that person isn't evil, but that is a bigoted point of view. They just don't know that they're bigoted. And so maybe the answer is to yell at them as I do often. And maybe part of the answer is to actually give them real facts. Anna.
Yeah, I mean, look, I just want to address that one of the answers there really stood out to me. And it was the woman whose husband is a truck driver. That's his livelihood. And she's frustrated about gas prices. And that goes to show you the impact of how our corporate media works, how the media ecosystem works. Because, and look, I'm not trying to go easy on Biden, but let's also keep it real. If the media did a good job explaining what it is that leads to a spike in gas prices, if there was a broad understanding among the American public about the OPEC cartel and the fact that the fossil fuel companies in this country are free to sell fossil fuels on the global market to the highest bidder. Meaning like this whole notion of like, oh, energy independence, we need to do more drilling and that'll make gas prices lower for all of us here in the United States. That is not true because that is not how it works out. It is not a nationalized system. These are multinational corporations that again, get to sell the fossil fuels to the highest bidder. That's usually what they do. But that goes to the point of a lot of them do have serious economic concerns. And I think that while Donald Trump doesn't actually legitimately address those concerns, he certainly does pay lip service to it. And at the same time, what aids and abets those lies is the terrible job the media does in explaining why it is we're experiencing what we're experiencing in our economy.
And what the Democrats do a terrible job. So that's why the guy says, and this was the most understandable of all the interviews. Somebody said, look, gas was around $1.30 when Trump was president, now it's around $3. And so I'm a blue collar worker, I have a lot less money on my table. And the Democrats' answer to that could be, hey guys, here's all the forces that are at play, and explain it clearly as Anna did, and I could add a couple more, and keep repeating that until it breaks through to people. Challenge the Republicans on it. Are you saying OPEC doesn't exist? Are you saying supply chain issues didn't happen, etc.? You could make all those arguments, right? But instead, the Democrats go, oh yeah, I passed a semiconductor bill. And the guy's like, how does that affect my life? I don't know how that affects my life. And everybody on cable news goes, semiconductor bill, semiconductor bill. Oh, Biden is so liberal, Biden is so wonderful, Biden did more bills than anyone else. Yeah, but did it affect their lives?
It affected their lives. There's construction of a chip factory that is, you know, that work is being done by workers who are brought in from other countries instead of, you know, employing American workers to do it.
And when people see that you brought in people from Taiwan to build your semiconductors that we gave them $52 billion in subsidies for, yeah, that doesn't make them very happy.
It does not.
Now, the reality is Trump never did anything for them either. The only thing he passed was tax cuts for the rich. But the Democrats are just awful at messaging, and you see it in these interviews.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.